We must love one another. When we stop seeing Israelis as apart from us, and instead as us, we can move to the next level as human beings. Life is just like a really cool 3D version of Angry Birds. You cannot move to the next level until you get it right. How many times is the Lord gonna give us the opportunity to get it right? Let's get it right this time.
The truth, the headlines, the blaze.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Amy Holmes, bringing you the stories we're following at theblaze.com. The founders of the new Egyptian Nazi Party are turning out to be surprisingly soft on a key tenet of Nazism. One of the party leaders said in an interview on Egyptian television that his organization does not harbor the same anti-Semitic sentiments that the German Nazi Party does, saying, quote, "We will not carry out Holocaust against the Jews, and we will not fight them. The one and only thing we have adopted from Nazism is racial supremacy. That's it." The Egyptian Nazi Party, while small, has national ambitions, hoping to elect its first representatives to the Egyptian parliament in the coming years. Continuing our coverage of the Days of Rage, a new documentary has hit the internets, shedding new light on the motives of the ragers. As the doc explains, the protests are a direct response, quote, to corporatism, fascism, and crony capitalism, as well as what they term an American police state and an American empire. Check out this protester whose motives appear a little bit more personally financial. Take a look.
If you're like me and, you know, you see the Tea Party on television and in the news all the time and you wonder why the hell isn't there a radical left answer to the Tea Party, you should be here.
You can watch the full video at theblaze.com. I'm Amy Holmes, bringing you the stories we're following here at The Blaze. We'll be back at the bottom of the hour.
I want to welcome a former Muslim who lived under Sharia law in Egypt for 30 years. She knows firsthand what Sharia law looks like. Nani Darwish is here. She is the author of Cruel and Unusual Punishment and director of Former Muslims United. Also back with us is Eric Stackelbeck, and he has been the terror expert for quite some time with CBN and joins us as well on some of our projects, and we appreciate it. I want to start with this. This is put out, and this is from the Center for American Progress, and it's called Fear Inc., which sounds an awful lot like Crime Inc., which we dubbed these people part of Crime Inc. Eric told me in the break they're more like Monsters Inc. But this is Fear Inc., the roots of Islamophobia network in America, and this names almost everybody I think is a good guy. It's Pat Robertson, John Hagee, Ralph Reed, Franklin Graham, Fox News, David Horowitz, Pamela Geller, Washington Times, The National Review, the Christian Broadcasting Network, The Clarion Fund, Rush Limbaugh, Sean Hannity, Michael Savage, Glenn Beck, Mark Levin, Brian Fisher. I mean, it's Michelle Bachmann. It's all of the people that will take any kind of stand. And they say that it is a conspiracy. It is a network that dits. I mean, this is... It's amazing that we get our marching orders from, I think, the Koch brothers, I'm not really sure, and we spread hatred for radicalized Islam. I want to share one more thing with the viewers, and then I want to talk about this and some other things. Right towards the, is it the end or is it the beginning? Tiffany, is it the beginning or the end? The very end. It talks about who has paid for this, and I think it is, here it is. I think it's fascinating. The authors of the editorial at the team of CAP, they want to thank the team of CAP, that Center for American Progress, blah, blah, blah. The report was supported in part by a grant from the Open Society Foundation, and we are grateful to them. This is George Soros's organization, and George Soros took another one of his organizations and helped pay for this. This is George Soros, and it has his fingerprints all over it. What we're seeing here has George Soros' fingerprints all over it. Am I mistaken on that, Nani?
You're right, because I think there is another organization that agrees with them, and it's the Iranian government has issued the same names, including myself, as Islamophobes in America. So they agree with the Iranian government.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were going to say?
I was going to say the Iranian government, Glenn, took this report, the Iranian government's official mouthpieces, including Press TV, which is Iranian-owned and operated, and which, by the way, has a bureau in Washington, D.C., around the corner from where I work, an Iranian entity. They took this, they reprinted the report on official Iranian government websites, and they played it on Iranian-run state TV. This is what George Soros is doing. He's giving ammunition to the Islamists, and Nani made a great point. For her to be on that list and for the Iranians to pick that up, that is the equivalent, in my mind, of a fatwa.
Hang on just a sec. We have a soundbite from this. I want you to see what Eric is talking about here. Go ahead, roll it.
Unfortunately, there's a growing host of people that appear to be benefiting from these campaigns. This report that was just released, titled Fear, Inc., The Roots of the Islamophobia Network in America, prepared by the Center for American Progress, is a very, very revealing report.
Pretty amazing. Okay, let me talk a little bit about Hizbut Tahrir, what we just watched. Who is involved and how big is it here in the United States?
It's like many places all over the world. It's been banned in many Arab countries. However, after the Arab Spring, they are starting to pop up again, having more power. They are banned in Russia because one of their leaders actually commanded Muslims in Chechnya to kill Russians who live in Chechnya. So they're quite subversive wherever they go. In several Muslim countries, they were standing against the leadership, the governments, who befriend America. So a major part of their activities is to punish Arab and Islamic government who befriend America. And on the other hand, so Arab countries end up banning them, but America is welcoming them with an open arms. They're going to be subversive in America. Welcome to the age of Islamic subversion in the United States of America.
Okay, let me ask you this. Are they the Black Panthers, which you want to pay attention to, but they're just a little player, or is this Al-Qaeda? Who are these guys?
It's much broader, because this is, unlike the Black Panthers, unlike the KKK, this is a global ideological movement. As you said, 43 countries at least. So this is a worldwide link. We said earlier in the show, links to Islamists in Great Britain, very dangerous guys, and I talked to an expert in Britain about this group, Glenn, about Hizbut Tahrir. He said they are a conveyor belt for terrorism. They'll take you right up to the point. They will ideologically indoctrinate you with hatred for the West, hatred for Jews. They will take you right up to the point, and then it's your choice whether you want to jump or not and be a suicide bomber. Many former Hizbut Tahrir members have graduated to Al-Qaeda, and I think that's an important point, because the Obama administration has not outlawed this group. The Obama administration
Well,
here's the deal. They believe that the Muslim Brotherhood and that Hizbut Tahrir, because they're not blowing anyone up yet, they must be moderate and they can be used as a counterweight to Al-Qaeda. They truly believe this, but at the end of the day, Glenn, Al-Qaeda, the violent wing of the jihad, and the Brotherhood, Hizbut Tahrir, they have the same goal. It's the same end game, Sharia for one and all, and the
Caliphate.
But
the Brotherhood, I mean, Nani, when you were watching, you're from Egypt. When you were watching the coverage of what was happening in Egypt and you heard every damn broadcaster in America say, this is fine. The Muslim Brotherhood, they're peace-loving.
Yeah, actually, a lot of people who started the revolution in Egypt are now very scared. Some of them want to leave the country because they have taken over. The Muslim Brotherhood have taken over. There is no Arab Spring. This is the beginning of, in my opinion, perhaps a civil war in many parts of the Arab world, because Islamists are in control of the majority of the population.
Yeah, but you have, I mean, we got this picture from you.
Yeah.
You found out about this. You
yes.
passed this on to us. This is explain who this is.
Yes, this is a Muslim man from Iraq who immigrated to America. He's been here for 2 years. He doesn't speak a lot of Arabic. And he,
you mean he doesn't speak a lot of English?
I'm sorry. He speaks only Arabic, does it? And he's been communicating with me a lot because I have a website called Arabs for Israel. And he wants to express his love for the Jewish people. And that, and he's criticizing quite a bit Islamic extremism and jihad.